You must have by now learned what is game mode of computer assisted instruction. There are so many advantages of game mode and there are some limitations also. If we discuss these advantages and limitations, we will be able to take wise decisions where to use game mode and where not to. Let's quickly see some advantages of game mode. If you go through various games, you will realize that games are highly flexible. There are so many choices, controls to the learners while playing games. So, the entire learning process becomes highly learner controlled. These games help in developing various cognitive skills. Learners learn logic. Learners learn how to solve problems. Learners learn to think creatively and divergently. Their interpersonal skills also get improved when they play with other learners. Their communication skills also may get improved when there are some communication packages, where are some players along with whom learners need to communicate. It also builds team spirit. These games cater to learners with different learning styles. Sometimes they like audio. Sometimes they like to solve problems. Sometimes they would prefer only drill and practice environment, but not combat mode. So learners have choices to play various games and they can decide which game to play depending on their own learning style. Games also help to develop risk-taking quality. Learners need to take risk, overcome some challenges, and that's why their decision-making ability, their communication ability, their risk-taking ability gets developed in a due course. Though there are so many advantages, there are some limitations also. If you talk about designing of a particular game, you must have realized that designing a game, developing a game is not an easy task. The writer should be very logical. The writer needs to take care of so many components, so many factors, so many decision-making routes. And ultimately, the actual production is expensive. So development of a game is a time-consuming and an expensive activity. Even if we develop a particular game, many a times there is conflict between characteristics of a game and learning environment. For example, combat games, even competition element. So some characteristics may affect the process of learning or it may be conflicting with values of the learner. So designing a game with proper balance between the learning ability of the learner and other characteristics of the game are generally difficult. Games are generally used for practicing, for developing logic skills. But games may not be useful for learning a new content altogether. There may be some limitations that the game mode cannot be used in this situation, cannot be used in that situation. So it's not always an effective mode. Even there are very negative beliefs about game mode for many educationists. As we have seen, there can be some conflicts, some value conflicts, and that's why educationists may not prefer game mode. Even learners may have some emotional challenges while playing games. Overplaying a game may affect learners' psyche. Sometimes learners get tense about winning, and that also creates negative impact on the learner. So we have to take care of all these negative factors while designing a game. Thank you.